I can get it to you. Someone said, maybe I can make it to you. And the devil said, where? Why are you there? And then he ties them down with great bondage. The brain is good, but the body is sick. The mind is sharp, but then the brain is tormented. The life has a great prospect in front of it, a great future. But then hindrances and disturbances and distractions tie them down. And it says this, such as sit in darkness. Eventually, they just sit down there in darkness. And they say, there's no use trying. There's no use trying to make it. They will not allow me over the day. God allows you. Jesus allows you. The promises of God allow you. And then I'm here and I release you. I allow you to go and succeed. Go and do well. Because the word of the Lord, the declaration of the man of God, is greater than that of Pharaoh, greater than that of Herod, and greater than that of Nebuchadnezzar. I release you, go and fulfill the will of God in your life in Jesus' name. But you know, they just sat down there in that place and besieged in the shadow of death. They see that death is near. And the shadow of death is hovering over them. And if they're helpless, their minds are paralyzed, their will tired, and their mind, they cannot even think afresh again and move on. And because of that, they're tied down in that affliction and iron. But this is the hour for your hour. I said, this is the hour for your hour. Let's look at Romans chapter 7. See another kind of bondage. Romans chapter 7, I'm reading from verse 14. Romans 7, verse 14. For we know that the law is spiritual, but I am carnal and sold under sin. The very first thing that ties a man is confession. The very first thing that makes a man not to be able to move out and move on is his own confession. I am carnal. What do you expect of me? I am carnal. Our family had that peculiar problem. We always fail when it comes to this. What do you expect of me? I am carnal. What do you expect of me? I'm just, you know, so and so. You know the tribe I come from? Nobody in our tribe ever does well, but you will do well. You can be the one that breaks that kind of thing. You can be the one that says, let's open the way. Open the way for our tribe. Open the way for our family. And if your family has never been any different, you are the one to open the way. Put the key in your hand, open that door. And move on in Jesus' name. What binds a man? What destroys a man? What keeps a man back? Is his confession. Look at verse 14 again. For we know that the law is spiritual. I'm different from the law, I am carnal. I'm sold under sin. And for that which I do, I allow not. That's his confession. What I do, I want to do well. I want to move up. I want to do better, but I'm helpless. That's your confession. Change that confession. I said, change that confession. You know, there are people, you know what happened last year now? You know what happened years before? You know what happened 10 years ago? You know what happened to the firstborn in a family? You know what happened to the second one and the third one? And now, it is my turn. It is not my turn. I said, it is not my turn. If you're talking about something spectacular, now it is my turn. If you're talking about the power of God, now it is my turn. If you're talking about a breakthrough, now it is my turn. If you're talking about miracle, now it is my turn. Are you there? It's your turn. I said it's your turn. But our senior brother Marie didn't have a child. My senior sister Marie didn't have a child. And then the third one married, and you know, she tried to have a child, and the child died at birth, and now I'm the number one, I'm the number four, I'm married. Now it is my turn. No, it's not your turn. No, it's not your turn. You will succeed in Jesus' name. 2 years ago in our school, the people that took at that NECO exam, they just cancelled everything. And last year, they took it again, they cancelled everything. Now it's my turn. Is it my turn? Is it your turn? No! You are the one to break that kind of bondage. And that bondage is broken in Jesus' name! But you see the confession of the people that do not understand that the power of God is there to break every bond. This day you are released. And the power of God is released to your life in Jesus' name. And it says, for that which I do I allow not. It says, I don't know myself. That's what the people say, that's their confession. I don't know myself. Don't blame me. That's just me. Well, it will change. Then it says, for what I would, I do not. But what I hate, that I do. You know, there are some people that say, they are getting to this bad habit. And you say, trust me, I don't want to do it. It's just, you know, I don't know. It's my destiny. Sinning will not be my destiny. I said sinning will not be my destiny. Say it for yourself. Sinning will not be my destiny. You see, my father was a tobacco smoker. His father, my grandfather, was a pipe smoker. And I learned that great-grandfather was marijuana smoker, and now it is my turn. It's your turn. What are you going to smoke? I said, what are you going to smoke? Now it's their turn. It is not my turn. I said, it is not my turn. That bad habit of smoking is broken in Jesus' name. It says, and if then I do pursue what I would not, I consent unto the law that is good. Now then, it is no more I that do it. You know what he's saying? I'm helpless, getting angry. It's not me, it's her family. Fighting is not me. It runs in our family. Wickedness is not me. It runs in our family because it's no more I that do it, but sin that dwelleth in me. For I know that in me, that is in my flesh. What's the next thing there? I say, what's the next thing there? Tell me out loud. It says, I know
that you have been blessed with this powerful message. Our address is at the bottom of the screen. I believe you will join us one of this Sunday to worship together. Thank you. God bless you. Let us pray. Our mighty Father, we glorify your name and thank you, Lord, because of this powerful message. I pray by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, you will touch those people who are in need of salvation. Those people who are in need of prosperity, those people who are in need of healing, and by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, they will give testimony because of this message. In Jesus' name we pray.
Say it one more time, say, oh, 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 Lord.